Project Prakash derives its name from the Sanskrit word for light. And the immediate goal is to bring light into the lives of children who are suffering from blindness. But in meeting this humanitarian need, as neuroscientists, we have an unprecedented opportunity, and that is to study how the brain learns to see once the blindness has been corrected. I became aware of the problem of childhood blindness in India and more broadly in the developing world. And I realized that many of the children who languish with their blindness have to lead very difficult lives. So it's a remarkable opportunity because surgically, one can transition a child from blindness to sight in a matter of literally half an hour. So from the very moment that the child's bandages are removed, you have a ringside seat into the process of visual development. The goal of Project Prakash is to merge the humanitarian outreach with the scientific study.
My main focus is working with the group of students and other scientists to conceptualize experiments and what the research questions are. And we have this art program that's called Unruly Art. And it started with the Prakash kids, where the idea is basically like art without rules. For Prakash kids, I think it's an amazing experience, first of all, just on a personal level to interact. They're very excited, especially after treatment. Providing them with the resources or the materials and letting them just experience it in whatever way they want and letting them work together in teams has been amazing.
So we get to study their development and we get to see how it changes and what their vision was like before they received surgery, and a lot of times a dramatic effect after surgery. My experiment looks at sensitivity to visual motion, and it's really remarkable to see that some kids, even with very impaired vision, they can still perform the task quite well. And then in other cases, there are cases of children who cannot perform the task. You see an improvement in performance after just one eye surgery.
Visual development is very unforgiving in terms of timing. Visual development proceeds very rapidly. In a matter of a few months, a baby is already a very sophisticated visual observer. Project Prakash provides an alternative way forward for understanding visual development, because you can have a 10-year-old child initiate sight in them through surgery. Then from the very first moments that the bandages come off, you can ask them fairly complex questions about what they're experiencing. You can design studies that would simply be out of the question to do with newborns.
Normally sighted newborn begins his or her visual journey with very poor acuity. In a child who has been born with cataracts, the retina still keeps maturing. So now let's say this child is 5 years old when you remove the cataract. This child will begin to see the world with that mature retina. So their initial acuity is going to be higher than the acuity of a normal newborn. And what we're proposing in this paper is that the lack of degraded vision that a normal child experiences, but that the newly sighted children did not, that is perhaps to blame for the subsequent challenges in face recognition and other aspects of object recognition.
Becoming involved in Project Prakash and really seeing the research and a lot of the kind of mechanisms that we think about in the lab setting actually unfold in real time with these children has a huge impact in making me understand that I can never go back to just doing research in the lab. You know, I have to find a way to do research that is going to help people and be involved in the community.
many of the Prakash children, even after they gain sight, are unable to start their educational journeys because they're considered too old, with the unfortunate consequence that they stay out of the schooling system, essentially for the rest of their lives. So we feel that we have to proactively take the first steps towards providing an education to these children using a specially designed educational program that can bring them to an age-appropriate level.